Awakening. Ben was half awake in the dark, propped up a little on his pillow, listening to the thunderstorm outside, with his mind drifting off to thoughts of wet pussies, firm tits and the hard cock in his hand. The door opens and silhouetted in the doorway is a young girl in her nighty, clutching her favorite teddy. The lightning flashes and he gets a momentary glimpse of her slim body through the thin fabric of her nightgown. Seconds later the thunder crashes and she comes running to his bed, begging to be let in. He throws back the covers and she leaps in and curls up next to his side. It is his little sister, Dawn, and she is terrified of thunderstorms. Their parents are away for the weekend and Ben is charged with the job of looking after his kid sister. She has drawn herself into a ball at his side, her face to his chest and her knees poking into his rib cage. He ignores the discomfort and draws the bed covers over her. He presses her closer and gently rubs her back through the covers. Scared? Yes, I hate storms, the shivering girl replies. Her muffled voice is barely heard above the rolling thunder outside. Ben continues to rub her back and eventually the shivering dries down. Slowly she straightens her body and slips into the depression made by his greater bulk. She is only 12, and still quite small. Her head is still nestled under his arm and he can feel her toes at his knees. She wriggles again, extracts an arm and drapes it across his chest. Ben cares a great deal for his sister. All the thoughts he was toying with before she arrived have long gone, and so has his erection. He slips the arm that is holding her below the covers and starts to rub her back again. His hand falls on her back just above her panties. The nightgown had bunched a little so he gently rubs her soft skin. Dawn is about to drift into sleep when a lightning bolt strikes close outside. The windows rattle as the thunder hits just seconds later. She is awake, terrified, again. Can I sleep on the other side? Against the wall? She backs of her brother. He agrees and she mounts his body to climb to the enclosed side of the bed. As she slides over him she presses her exposed stomach across the boy's soft penis. Juices from his earlier thoughts still lingered within him and are smeared across her delicate skin. You're wet. Yeah, sorry. Ben was not trying to turn this into sex. He had made a promise to his mother that he would leave Dawn innocent until the time was right. How come? Is it pee? Dawn was puzzled. Her mother had given her the sex talk, and in her mind if this wasn't pee then Ben must have been having sex with someone. No. It's not pee. Ben left it there. If he said more it would lead to a conversation he did not want to start. He hoped that Dawn would drop it. Then what is it? Dawn knew what the alternative was, but she was not letting go. It's seminal fluid. He figured if he used the technical terms she might drop the subject. He was dead wrong. So who have you been having sex with? It's only you and me at home. I wasn't having sex with anyone. I was just starting to jerk off when you came in. Jerk off. Dawn was still puzzled. Jerk off. Masturbate? To have sex with yourself. Do you ever play with yourself? Sometimes. She said, hesitantly. And when you do, does your vagina get wet? Yes. She replied, again hesitantly. Well, the same happens for boys. Fluid comes out of our penis and makes it all wet and slippery. Can I see? She shot back, starting to lift the covers to see his penis. Hang on, hang on ... You're a bit young to be getting into all this. Into all what? This was getting serious. She hated being told she was too young for anything. Sex. Too young for sex. You're only 12, he said in his best fatherly tone. She wasn't buying it. I am not. Now show me your penis. She shot back. He could tell him from her voice that she was not going to give up. He reached over and switched on the lamp next to his bed. He drew back the covers to expose his soft pink member. Dawn sat up in bed next to him and looked down at his body intently. He reached down and lifted his cock into the air. As he did so, he squeezed the base and a bead of clear fluid emerged from the head. Can I touch? She asked, softly. She had seen his penis many times in the swimming pool in sauna. She had even seen him pee a few times, but always at a distance. She had never wanted to get up close and personal until now. Sure, but be careful. I don't need you stabbing me with your fingernails. Dawn reached down and touched the tip of his cock with her index finger. She rubbed the head a little and the boy's juice coated the end of her finger. She lifted her hand and rubbed the juice between her finger and thumb. It is slippery. Mom, never told me why that was. How was he going to answer that? Was she ready to be told about fucking? It's a lubricant. It makes skin slip along other skin. You said that when you play with yourself your vagina got wet and slippery? Yes, a lot. Well, the stuff that comes out of my cock is the same. It means that the soft skin doesn't get all rubbed up when I rub it with my hand. Can I touch you again? The boy nodded and Dawn reached down to his cock again. This time she held the filling shaft in her hand and slid his juices over him. Her touch aroused him quickly. Soon she was holding the base of his erect shaft. By instinct she started to slide her hand up and down his pole. It's big. She said in an impressed tone. Am I hurting you? No. You're doing fine. Keep rubbing it up and down. Just make sure your hand is always wet and slippery. Okay? Dawn continued to pump her brother's cock. This was new and fun. He looked up at her and saw the pleasure and wonder on her face. He lay back and let her jerk him off. Neither of them had noticed that the thunder had ceased and the storm had moved away. Dawn shuffled a little and sat herself, cross-legged, next to his hip. She was settling in. Ben glanced down at her and saw her beautiful young legs and the panty-covered crotch between them. He allowed his thoughts wander to the pussy within and Dawn's words about making herself wet a lot. Dawn was now using both hands to pump her brother's cock. He could feel his load welling inside him. He figured he'd go the next step. Suck it. Your penis? She questioned. My cock. Yes. Suck the end of it and taste my juice. She had come this far, he thought. Just keep your teeth away. Okay? Dawn bent forward and took the head of his cock inside her mouth. She milked him with her hands and felt the liquid emerge on her tongue. She moved her mouth around and he felt her lips slide on his hard shaft. See how far down you can go, he suggested, desperate now for the hot whiteness deep in her throat. Dawn took a breath and plunged her face down on his cock. Her lips slid less than halfway down his 7-inch member. She lingered there a moment then withdrew completely. She hovered above him for a while to compose herself, drew another breath and went down again. This time she knew what to expect and pushed down harder. She felt his cock press against the back of her throat. She lifted, took a breath and down again. This time she arched her back and straightened her throat. She felt his cock slide further this time as her lips almost made it to the base of his shaft. His pubic hair began to tickle her nose. She pumped him with her mouth some more until he spoke again. I'm going to come soon. Sit back and just use your hands ... and watch. Just wait. He knew the cum would go everywhere but figured she needed to see it fly. He lay back and turned his thoughts back to his sister's wet pussy. Seconds later he blew. His cock was leaning Dawn's way so she copped most of his load. She had cum in her hair, on her face and a big blob on the front of her nighty. He looked up and saw that there was even a bit on the wall behind her. Oh? You could hear the surprise and admiration in her voice. I didn't think it would come out that quick. As the last of his load oozed over her hands Dawn looked down. She could now see that cum really was thick and white. It was all over her hands. She held them up with a puzzled look on her face. She glanced around looking for some way to deal with the mess. Lick it off, Ben chimed in. It won't hurt you. Women have been swallowing cum for thousands of years. Dawn hesitated a moment longer then began to clean her paws like a young kitten. First the right, then the left. Ben sat up a little and saw the blob of cum on her cheek. He reached over and lifted it off with his finger. He held it in front of her like a trophy. This is semen, or just cum if you like. This much could make 1,000 babies, so watch out. He held it aloft. Dawn took his wrist, pulled it toward her and licked the cum from his finger.